That interview with Nirmala Sitharaman coming up in about 30 minutes. But first, the Prime Minister began his election blitz in Karnataka today, where he will address 15 rallies in the next 5 days. Today, he did 3 rallies and spent most of them talking about Rahul Gandhi and attacking him. From jibes against the dynasty to a dig at his mother's Italian origins, everything was on the table. The Congress also hit back. Clearly, this isn't just the Karnataka election campaign anymore. It looks very much like a general election campaign.
The Prime Minister chose Chamarajnagar, an area seen as a stronghold of the Congress Chief Minister, to launch his series of rallies. Mr. Modi opened his Karnataka campaign with a direct repartee and attack on the Congress Chief Rahul Gandhi.
Congress Adhyaksh ji ne haal hi mein mujhe ek chunauti di. Unhone kaha agar main sansad mein 15 minute bolunga to Modi ji baith bhi nahi payenge. आपने सही फरमाया है. हम आपके सामने नहीं बैठ सकते. हम तो अच्छे कपड़े भी नहीं पहन सकते हैं. आपके सामने बैठने का हमें हक कहां पे हो सकता है.
15 मिनट मेरी वहां पे मोदी जी के सामने स्पीच करा दो. 15 मिनट में राफेल की बात करूंगा, नीरव मोदी की बात करूंगा. मोदी जी वहां पे खड़े नहीं रह पाएंगे.
And while the Prime Minister spoke extensively about the 100% electrification of India's villages, there were a series of attacks on, among others, Sonia Gandhi's Italian origin, a plank the BJP has used off and on since she first entered politics over 20 years ago.
आपको जो भाषा पसंद हो उस भाषा में, हिंदी बोल सके तो हिंदी, अंग्रेजी बोल सके तो अंग्रेजी. आपकी माताजी की मातृभाषा बोल सके तो मातृभाषा. 15 मिनट हाथ में कागज लिए बिना कर्नाटक की आपकी सरकार की अचीवमेंट कर्नाटक की जनता के सामने बोल दीजिए. 2005 में उस समय की सरकार के प्रधानमंत्री मनमोहन सिंह जी ने कहा था कि वे देश के हर गांव में 2009 तक बिजली पहुंचा देंगे. 2014 तक आप बैठे थे, मेरे आने तक आप बैठे थे, क्यों काम नहीं किया. मुख्यमंत्री तो इधर उधर से भाग रहे हैं, सीट छोड़ करके ना दौड़े भागे जा रहे हैं. और यहां पहले लड़ रहे थे, जनता ने आशीर्वाद दिया था, वहां बेटे को बलि चढ़ाने के लिए लगा के रख दिया है.
एक तरफ एडी गैंग है, एक तरफ रेड्डी गैंग है. एक तरफ वो मुख्यमंत्री पद के दावेदार बैठे हैं जो 25 दिन जेल काटकर आए हैं, और एक तरफ चीफ कैंपेन मैनेजर जनार्दन रेड्डी हैं जिनके मुकदमों को मोदी जी बंद करने में लगे हैं.
द प्रेजेंस ऑफ बीएस येडियुरप्पा एट द रैली, देयर हैज बीन स्पेक्युलेशन दैट प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी वुड नॉट शेयर द स्टेज विद बीएस येडियुरप्पा, दैट बीएस येडियुरप्पा इज बीइंग यूज्ड एज अ टारगेट बाय द कांग्रेस टू अटैक द बीजेपी ऑन करप्शन. Significantly, at a later rally, the Prime Minister attacked the Congress to praise the Janata Dal secular chief Devegowda, who many see as a kingmaker in the case of a hung verdict.
जिस प्रकार से आदरणीय देवगौड़ा जी का उल्लेख कर रहे थे, क्या ये आपके संस्कार है? अरे अभी तो आपकी जिंदगी की शुरुआत हो रही है. अरे देवगौड़ा जी तो इस देश के वरिष्ठ नेताओं में से एक है.
Chamarajnagar was the very first stop, but he will be addressing 15 rallies across 5 days across the state. With Govind Murthy, Maya Sharma in Chamarajnagar for NDTV.
Meanwhile, hours after Prime Minister Modi introduced his Namdar versus Kamdar jeer for Rahul Gandhi in Karnataka, Union Minister Piyush Goyal borrowed the phrase to hit back at the Congress president for a tweet targeting him over allegations of impropriety. Rahul Gandhi and the Congress have been demanding Mr. Goyal's resignation following a report in The Wire on the minister's alleged impropriety and conflict of interest. It involves a private company called Flashnet. The Wire reports that Piyush Goyal owned this company along with his wife, and just months after becoming a minister, he sold it off at nearly 1,000 times its face value to the Piramal Group, which also had interests in the power sector where Goyal was a minister. Both have denied any wrongdoing. Mr. Goyal tweeted that he was a kamdar, a worker, and not a namdar, a dynast like Rahul Gandhi, saying that till 26th of May 2014, before I became a minister, I was a professional chartered accountant and investment banker. And unlike you, Mr. Gandhi, have not learnt well the art of living without working. I am also a kamdar. Well, Rahul's tweet this morning had listed 3 points to justify his demand for Mr. Goyal's resignation. A graphic linked to his tweet alleged that the minister sold the stock of his company at 1,000 times the face value while he was still in the power ministry. The purchaser, the Piramal Group, had an interest in the power sector, Mr. Gandhi alleged. Well, let's listen in to the BJP's defense of the union minister.
The Congress party is a party that always did corruption, practiced corruption. And they are so involved with corruption that they have corruption in their head, so they see corruption in everything, a scam in everything. Mr. Piyush Goyal is a well-known chartered accountant. He's a professional. It's but natural that his work would be valued at something, because even an ordinary chartered accountant can explain to Rahul Gandhiji, there is something called goodwill, what is the potential, what is the valuation is based on that. 2, 3, 4 times is not some exceptional valuation. It's not 500 times or 5,000 times or something like that. And therefore, Piyush Goyal ji, if he has come out and called it a political hit job, he's absolutely correct.
Well, joining us on NDTV tonight, we have Dr. Vaman Acharya, senior leader of the Karnataka BJP, and its spokesperson Danish Ali of the JDS joining us in Delhi tonight. Vinam Shastri of the Congress Party is with us this evening. Mr. Deshratan Nigam, lawyer and member of the RSS. Also with us, Shivam Village, columnist with The Print. Let's first talk about, and I want to first talk about these allegations that Piyush Goyal is facing, because that seems to Shivam Village have become an extension of this Karnataka campaign. He's denying any wrongdoing. This has clearly become an all-out political war. Do his explanations hold up? Because the main charge seems to be that he did not disclose that he owned this company and that he then sold it in his assets declarations to the Prime Minister's office.
Right. The non-disclosure is an important issue, because if there is no wrongdoing, then why was the disclosure hidden, right? He's supposed to disclose it. All ministers are supposed to declare their assets every year to the Prime Minister. But I think beyond that, just look at the irony of the situation, where corruption was a major issue in 2014 elections, and today a serious corruption charge is being made, and the government does not even feel the need to have an inquiry. We are supposed to believe that Mr. Piyush Goyal has done no wrong because the BJP says so, because Mr. Piyush Goyal says so, because he is a great chartered accountant, so he couldn't have made any error in those transactions amounting to any corruption or wrongdoing. There is no, on the same government which is reopening Bofors cases, right, going so far back. In this case, no CBI, no ED, no judicial inquiry, no parliamentary committee. Of course, we don't have a Lokpal, 4 years after an election which Lokpal was an issue. So, you know, as a lay person, I don't claim to understand these financial details, and unlike Mr. Piyush Goyal, I'm not a chartered accountant, and neither are you.
But we are kamdhar.
After we are kamdhar, but after some serious allegations have been made, and made in great detail with supporting documents and evidence, the least we can have, we deserve is an inquiry. We're not saying Mr. Piyush Goyal is guilty. Maybe he's not. In the case of Mr. Jay Shah, it is important to note, he himself went and filed a defamation case saying, I'll prove myself innocent.
Or at the very least, a more detailed explanation. Mr. Nigam, I'll just ask you on that briefly as well. There are two things here. One is the non-disclosure. One is conflict of interest. Whether as power minister, you should be doing business with a corporate house that also has interests in the same sector in which you are minister. It's a clear conflict of interest then. Do we need to hear more on this from Piyush Goyal, from the BJP? Are you convinced?
See, I'm certainly convinced with Mr. Piyush Goyal, although the answer, as I have always said on your channel, that should come from BJP, not from the RSS. They are probably in the know of the things. But
you are their mother, grandmother.
I'm fine, but we don't deal with them on one-to-one basis, on a daily basis. And we have a coordination mechanism, as I have already told you, guiding them on policy matters. Now, before we come to the conclusion, we need to understand the dates. July, the sale of FlashNet took place. 25th July 2014, the minister files his assets and liabilities. He has already offloaded most of the things at that point in time. point of time, he has already reflected in those assets the sale proceeds and everything in his affidavit
in declaration
to the Rajya Sabha.
He's already, not to the PMO.
No, to the Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha is probably the higher body. It's a more accountable body. And he has already declared it so. And the valuation done by a third party independent chartered accountant valuer has been taken on record and proven. If anybody has a problem, they can go to the court.
Should he be doing business with a corporate house?
He was not at that point of time.
He was.
The moment he became a power minister, he offloaded everything.
Should any minister be doing business with a corporate house?
No, he had...
It opens up huge questions of potential conflict of interest.
It is not doing business. It is having shares. Anybody is entitled, you, me, anybody is entitled to have shares in a company, which he did.
It's a transaction with a corporate house.
No, it's a share. Buying and purchasing is... Anybody is entitled in law.
It's a business transaction.
No, please tell me, is he barred in law? No, he is not barred under law. One. Secondly, he offloaded the moment he became power minister to avoid that conflict of interest. That's what I am saying. If anybody has a problem, you may approach any authorities under the law.
Okay, a quick response from the Congress, and then we'll move on to the Karnataka part.
4 months after he became a minister.
No, not in September. No, that's the conflict. That's a conflict of dates. It is what you're saying is September 2014, and what actually happened was in July.
Well, the Wire insists it was September 2014.
Wire is not the gospel truth.
No, they're the ones who've done the story, sure, and they claim they have supporting documents. This is their claim.
They have supporting claim, and we have copies of it, which we can share later. But I'll tell you, I think also if you look at the kind of valuation numbers which Nalin Kohli was talking about, the 300-400, I mean, the time of sale, the net profit of this company was 34 lakhs, right? And you sell it for 48 crores. So I really don't understand. And if there is some secret recipe which can, give us such humongous profits and huge valuations, I'll be very happy to know. In fact, on one end where you have such enormous amount of unemployment, etc., and somebody's talking of pakoda, paan, and everything, and give us this secret recipe. I think it may change.
Let me ask you just for a minute.
I think if you look at the movement of Sensex from 18,000 to 35,000, these valuations are well within the reach.
I'm not an expert on that. But the question to ask the BJP Dr. Acharya is that, how come a lot of the Prime Minister's speech actually focused on Rahul Gandhi? Is Rahul Gandhi the election issue in Karnataka? Or what about the issues? Where have they gone? Development, Vikas. I've been looking for Vikas for many years. But, what happened to those issues? Why was this such a Rahul Gandhi, Gandhi family-centric campaign today?
Rahul Gandhi makes any public meeting interesting. When you take the name of Rahul Gandhi, people will clap and enjoy the jokes. That is the reason that he has picked up Rahul Gandhi for his speech, only to start his speech with an entertainment. Baki sab jo hai, whatever later he has told about development, about what is happening in that area, is all serious talk. Don't take comments on Rahul much serious, because everybody in Karnataka knows that he, in front of Siddaramaiah, he is nobody in Karnataka. Still he comes
but
and makes speeches.
He's nobody, but still the Prime Minister focuses so much of his attention on Rahul Gandhi. Amazing.
I told you, you take it little light. Why are you so serious about that? See, political speeches
also have to be
a little entertaining also.
So election speeches
should
be entertaining, sir?
Have to be a little entertaining as well.
So election speeches should be entertaining. Is that what you're telling us?
Also, especially if you take the name of Rahul Gandhi, it will entertain the people.
Karnataka people have taken Rahul. But Dr. Acharya, I can understand if you said that if the PM spent 30 seconds of his speech talking about Rahul, he has spent such a huge amount of his speech attacking Rahul Gandhi and the Congress and the Gandhi family. He spoke on Rahul Gandhi,
he spoke on his mother, but at the same time, he spoke also on the misdeeds that they have done. And whatever good has been done by the central government, That also he has told. But
Was the jibe about his mother's mother tongue necessary? Have we not moved on from the Italian origin debate? Or we're going to be stuck in a time warp?
These are public speeches where, you have to remind people from where this whole hallagulla has started. It is not an original hallagulla, it is imported hallagulla. That's what Modi ji has said to the public.
A person called
Rahul Gandhi cannot
how
face
is he
people
imported?
Or public or any questions
how is he
for
imported?
More than 15 minutes. Because he has been made important by Congress here in Karnataka. Because
is there a
Karnataka
problem in that, sir?
Probably is the only state where he can come.
You can
where
come
he can give a speech. In other states, he cannot. He is a figure who can entertain people. So he has referred. What is wrong there?
Well, I want to first ask Shivam about this attack on Rahul before I come to Danish Ali about the praise for Devi Gowda. What do you make of this? I mean, is this Narendra Modi trying to make this about Modi versus Rahul, in which he generally comes across, I think, to his voters as looking better? Is he setting the stage for 2019 and not really about Karnataka?
Well, a couple of things. One, it is about Karnataka, because in Karnataka, Siddaramaiya, who is a regional stalwart, has been very smartly trying to make it a Siddaramaiya versus Yediyurappa, Siddaramaiya versus Modi battle. Just like Nitish Kumar had in 2015 made it Nitish versus Modi and said for Bihar it is Nitish, or Arvind Kejriwal had done the same in 2015, the regional leader saying, I am here, but who is your CM candidate? Is Yediyurappa? No, I am better. Modi therefore is trying to take it where his strength lies. Modi's strength lies in Karnataka, not in Yediyurappa, but in Modi. So he is trying to make it Modi versus Rahul to diminish the Siddaramaiya factor. He's trying to tell the voters of Karnataka, don't vote for on account of Siddaramaiya, vote on account of me, because I am better than Rahul. That's one. Secondly, it's been a pattern for the last few months, actually, that the BJP at the highest levels has been giving a lot of importance to Rahul Gandhi.
Exactly. Every time he says
BJP
something, a minister
itself,
comes out and attacks him.
In fact, the gentleman here was saying Rahul Gandhi is a matter of humor and jokes and so on. Actually, it is the BJP which created his image, his Pappu image, of one of ridicule, and it is now the BJP which has made him look better and more acceptable by actually taking him very seriously. Because, until some months ago, the BJP's answer to Rahul Gandhi was only Smriti Irani. It was Rahul versus Smriti for BJP. Today, Prime Minister Modi, although he still did not name Rahul, he didn't say the word Rahul, as far as I saw, he said Congress president.
No, he said Rahul ji.
In the first speech, I think he didn't say Rahul. But anyway, I might be wrong, but he referred to Rahul anyway, whether or not he named him. In doing so, it is no longer a Smriti versus Rahul battle. It is a Modi versus Rahul battle nationally. Why? Because for the past few months, Prime Minister Modi has been trying to say, even if I failed, because all these questions of jobs and farmers.
Look what they did in the past.
Even if I failed, I am better than Congress on all counts, be it on corruption, be it on leadership, be it on intention. Even if I fail, my intention
so
is
let me get Vinamrita.
Last point. The other thing is, this might be a mistake, because just as forever it's been said that attacking Modi only helps him, he rises, attacking Rahul might actually be helping Rahul. The BJP might be making a mistake here.
Well, a quick comment from you, Vinamrita, on the Karnataka BJP's take on this.
No, I think it's absolutely ridiculous. I mean, what you said about Rahul being, someone who's used for entertainment, I think it's absolutely ridiculous. I mean, it's not right to say such things. And in fact, as a prime minister, you are a prime minister of the country first and a party later. So I think it's absolutely unacceptable for a prime minister to go on a public meeting and say such things about Rahul Gandhi, his mother tongue. Of course, you can come and dare anyone, but you can't dare and then start putting your,
personal
attacks, mother's mother tongue, etc. And I'm telling you, culturally, the way our value systems are, this is not going to go well. And I agree with you. I mean, this is absolutely going to go in our favor. And as far as Rahul Ji's emergence is concerned, he was already a very big leader for us. He will be a leader for us. in the future, and we are sure under his leadership we'll come back.
Well, Danish Ali, the other interesting sidelight to everything that happened today was the Prime Minister's great praise for Mr. Devegowda, which has only strengthened what is being whispered in political circles now for some time, that you are essentially working for the BJP in this election.
See, Nidhi, one must accept that Prime Minister is a very eloquent Hindi speaker, and he is master in exploiting the sentiments. See, what happened is when Mr. Rahul Gandhi goes to Hassan, the former Prime Minister's constituency, and attacks Devegowda ji and JDS, and when Mr. Rahul Gandhi's nominee, Mr. Sidaramaiya, removes Devegowda ji's portrait from the Chief Minister's office, who Devegowda ji himself was the Chief Minister, he is the only Kannadiga who has been the Prime Minister of this country, and his photo was thrown out. So Mr. Modi is trying to exploit those sentiments of Kannadigas, whereas Mr. Rahul Gandhi has not even still realized that he has become the President of the Indian National Congress. He has a more responsibility to take all regional secular forces together. And he still reads out the slips given by the local Congress leaders in the constituency of Devegowda ji, that JDS is a B team of BJP. This type of attack should not come out from Mr. Rahul Gandhi, the President of the Indian National Congress. Okay, if some local Congress leader says this, allegations are made, that is a different thing. But you have Mr. Devegowda himself has told categorically to Dr. Pranav Roy in an interview, no question of supporting BJP. That interview the Honorable Prime Minister might have seen, and to misguide the people of Karnataka, to exploit the sentiments of Kannadigas, the Prime Minister might have used this, as the BJP spokesperson himself has said that Prime Minister was just entertaining the people of Karnataka. Now you yourself can realize that how serious one should take the speech of Honorable Prime Minister today.
I'm trying to get my head around this because not only JDS saying we shouldn't take the Prime Minister's speech seriously, are you kidding me? On Srimati Soniangandhi and her mother tongue, we don't endorse that.
Okay. It is in bad taste, it is below the belt.
Well, that is an important point you made, but are you saying that we don't take the Prime Minister's speech seriously? That we shouldn't take the Prime Minister's speech seriously?
No, it's the BJP spokesperson who has just accepted it. Who has said it? It's not I am saying it. It is the BJP spokesperson who has accepted it. The Prime Minister, I told you that Prime Minister Modi is an expert in exploiting the sentiments. It is a mistake made by Mr. Rahul Gandhi and Mr. Sidaramaiya by removing Mr. Devegowda's portrait from the Chief Minister's office. It was a mistake by Mr. Rahul Gandhi comparing JDS as a B team of BJP. See, JDS is always against BJP. Yes, we are fighting against Congress in Karnataka, but we are part and parcel of opposition unity against Narendra Modi government. And we hope the people of Karnataka are going to bless JDS-BSP alliance with full majority. It's not, see, secularism and the opposition, this thing is not the, only the prerogative of Congress itself. When Sanjay Nirupam leaves Shiv Sena, joins Congress, he becomes secular. When Narayan Rane leaves Shiv Sena, joins Congress, becomes secular. See, this is not the way the Congress is basically has used its energy to eliminate the secular regional forces. If they could have kept this energy and fought BJP, today BJP would not have been ruling this country.
Okay, so you're
insisting more interested in fighting regional forces than fighting BJP.